We said this workshop as a pre-calculus. Then what is calculus? Quite obvious. We all know what calculus is. Probably would be interested in knowing what pre-calculus is all about. Okay. I have planned to give two lectures. And I have titled my talks as Understanding Sets. That's one thing. And also functions. So, most of the time I will be looking at this aspect of the theme. And let me see how one can motivate our understanding of sets and functions. We all know, because we have been teaching students right from our high school in the math curriculum, that students are introduced to set theory at the very early stage because of the kind of sophistication or modernity that entered into the realm of mathematics. So I should say George Cantor is the George Cantor in the late 1900s initiated set theory, foundations of set theory in the modern parlance. Set theory we can attribute to Cantor. Cantor also did not live for long. Yeah, he had a very disturbed life. But nevertheless, there were some ambiguities also later on cleared by the set theory propounded by Cantor. Neyman himself does those things in a very systematic way. So that all goes into the history. All right. Now we are using this theory to understand mathematics, rather I would say. Whether it be calculus or it is geometry or algebra, whatever it may be, the bread and butter for this is set theory. So how do you conceive a set? And once you conceive a set, so I need to know what this set is about. And then something like, you know, you give a birth to some idea and then see how this idea develops. So the seeds, and then see how it sprouts, and then sapling grows into a big tree. This is the natural process. Calculus is like that. Okay, and then I'm not looking at very abstract things here. For me, sex means what? Well, if I take the most simplest example, I would call, this is also abstract, is space a set? That is my question. Is space a set? Then what is the space? You also ask this question. So supposing I consider myself living in this room, and this room living in a three-dimensional space, that is a space where we all live. If I take that as a, can I take that as a set? That's my feeling. Or something, a rectangular box, okay, some nice rectangular, all these axes are at right angles, straight lines are straight lines only. My figure doesn't replicate in that true sense a rectangle. You can imagine a diluted box, some kind of thing. Is it a set? Or a sphere, nice three-dimensional, you can say, not a solid sphere for that matter, hollow sphere, like your soccer ball. Are they sets? Yes or no? Are they? Yes or no? If yes, why? If no, why?
After Descartes,
yes, you are right. After. So it was René Descartes, around 14th century, a French philosopher turned mathematician, comes up with what is known as Euclid formulates a very nice Euclid's model for geometry. Okay, your writing board, if you take this as a plane, this is also a set. The writing board that I have here is also a set. Okay, Euclid took this, okay, and then we tell student, by set we mean collection of well-defined objects, an aggregate, and if I pick one element of this aggregate, I can for sure say that this would belong to this set or it doesn't belong to this set, something like that. If I put oranges into this box and then say I call this set of oranges, put in the box, if I pick one orange, I'm for sure that it's an orange because I put all the oranges into the box, they're going to belong to this set. And now there are also things that are there outside. There are also oranges. I don't say that these are also oranges. Outside, oranges, inside, there's no distinction. Am I right? But here, see, even though they are oranges, some of them belong and some of them do not belong to this set. Okay. See, if I say apples, I can clearly say, apple doesn't belong to this set of oranges. I can see that membership is very clear. So that's what. But sometimes you can also discern these things. Means, I can consider this room as a bounded region, bounded by these walls, a roof, we're all inside, okay? No soul is can be imagined residing outside as an element inside. Same is the case, all right? Okay, so this kind of distinctions also become very clear. So, though the space looks so abstract, people started looking at them as sets and then said that the points of the space, points or elements, That's what Euclid said, elements. Okay? You take points, then he says lines. A line is a set consisting of all conglomerate of all points lying on it. Unless I define what a line is, that is a different story. Okay, to define a line again, I need a great many ideas. Again, as he said, right later, René Descartes has to come here on those things. So, a line comes up, okay, some n points in general position will make up some closed figure. So, if three points are there on a plane like this, in a general position, if I join, that's what Euclid says. Any two points would determine a unique line passing through those two points. This is axiom, Euclid's axiom in a geometry model of Euclid's model. So, and three choose two. I have three lines. So L1, L2, L3 extended both ends. But the region that you see here is some closer figure you get, a triangle you get. The minimum that you need to distinguish from point to a line to a triangle, and then you are into space. That's why you said that coplanar and then non-coplanar kind of a thing. So I take four points, three points coplanar lie in the same plane, the other one lies outside the plane. Now I get a tetrahedron or a polygonal kind of a figure, something that you get on those things. So clearly it gives you, though this is an abstract idea, gives you to think very concretely in this fashion. And then the geometric attribute was so nearer to them because they were feeling, they were meddling with balls, they were meddling with these rectangular regions, triangular regions, all those things, so they were there, okay. And therefore, it is not surprising to see that this abstraction was there earlier even before Cantor could pronounce it and develop a theory for sets and all those things. Okay, I do not start with an abstract set like this X. I don't do that. After all, for mathematics, what is required is numbers. Okay, if I can relate R is equals to the set of reals as the points on the line, only our real numbers are the points on the real line. Now I regard this R as a set of real line, real numbers. Alright, so I draw this line, I take a pen, I call this as a real number. That may be a point on this set R. That number is real. Like your root 2 or pi. Alright? And now, then the tendency to look at these things is that is something, it doesn't come with as a platter, but I would see in a natural way, this has the best examples as sets for at least the number sets are concerned. Natural numbers. N, 1, 2, 3. Something like I had one fruit, orange, I ate it. Then I'm left with no fruit. Because to begin with, the moment I came into existence and I experienced the nature, I could find one orange. That is why it was already there, one orange was there. Zero oranges must be there, but I was not in this universe to declare zero. And that's why they don't take zero as in the set of natural numbers. The moment I consume this orange, no more oranges, eyesight, zero. I look for more oranges. So, nature is so bounty, there are plenty of oranges. Alright, so the basic arithmetic operations that you perform on these sets will land you up into integers. So these integers, minus 1, I said, I borrow 1, I had 1, I finished it, and then whether I accumulate them or I eat them up or I give them in anticipation that I am going to get it back, all these things are reflected in this set. This is sort of integers. And then there were also nice things, okay? So you were so generous, you know, you were dividing, okay? So rationals came up. So these rationals, they are of the type M upon N, M and integers. They have no common factor and all that, and it's positive. Then you are into this R. This R, reals. Then there is some thing that I need to mention about these things. Now there are some numbers which cannot be expressible in the form M upon N, and therefore I will have to live with them. The first number that you encounter is your root 2. Your root 2 was such a number that you encountered because of Pythagoras theorem. So you look at the Cartesian plane, okay, you take a Cartesian plane, you look at this origin, you take one unit, and then think of a right triangle with this as x, this as y. What you would get is x square plus y square. If this is of one unit, this is of one unit, then you get this hypotenuse as root 2. Root 2 is not commensurable. I cannot get exact length of the root 2. I cannot measure this and then say that this is the length of root 2. Am I right?
You can get the length by compass.
Exactly, yeah. I can't express this. Yeah.
Sir, you define the rational.
Yeah.
N is less than 0.
Pardon?
Rational set of rational.
It can be negative, positive are there, no?
It cannot be equal to
0. Something that appears, something that appears in the denominator as 0 is forbidden.
You cannot say strictly greater than, but less than or
more. Oh yeah. You mean yeah. Okay. You want to? No, I usually take n positive because m can This is much simpler. This is simpler. If you say N positive, even M could be negative. Okay? So you can always observe. So I don't attach this minus to this. This is same as all this. The dichotomy, you have to just do that. It's a good observation, yeah. All right. So, this is okay. These number sets are really interesting. Okay. What do you mean by understanding them? So, I need to look into... See, the moment I need to structure them, that's what they say in the... So, can you structure these numbers, this sets? So, if I have a set X, I need to structure this set with some structure. Wait. Can I do that for integers? So, I take this. Can I structure this? Let us see what will happen now. You pick at will any two integers. All right, you take M, N, two integers, add them, what you will get, Asma? M, N, I, L, again it's an integer, right? So, you can freely do this. If you subtract, if you add, you can freely do this, okay? Now, I make a small notation here. So, I will define this as integers, okay? I will say integers up to, I don't mind putting this also. All right, up to L. First L positive integers including 0 as my ZL. This is quite natural with NK. There's a standard notation. First K natural numbers. I didn't take this. I take this. Similar kind of a thing that I look at. This is very familiar to us. This set is finite. Unlike set of natural numbers, that's infinite. This is finite. It contains exactly k natural numbers. First k natural numbers. I don't start somewhere and then end up with k numbers. If it is nm, first m. So if k is less than m or equal to this, then cardinality of nk is less than or equal to cardinality of nm. That's what I mean. Sizes of the sets. Now I have a small submission here. Now you do this, you at will you pick two integers from this basket, add them. Say, okay, my L is 12, something like this. All right, you take any two, thoda kijiye, maramat. What will happen? 1 plus 2, no problem. 0 plus 1, no problem. 1 plus 9, no problem. Probably 0, 6 plus 6 is no problem. 7 plus 6 is 13. It's not there. You are going out of this. 6 plus 6 is not. Pardon? 6 plus 6 is not. 12. Yeah, you are right. Yeah. It's not there. You got my point. Okay. isn't it? This is a problem. If you take finite sets and you start doing these things, soon you will be into problems. So infinite sets gives you that comfort. ಪಾಕೆಟ್ ತುಂಬ ರೊಕ್ಕ ಇದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಖರ್ಚು ಮಾಡಿ ಇನ್ನೂ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಇನ್ನೂ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಆ ಮಾಲ್ಗೆ ಹೋದೆ, ಈ ಮಾಲ್ಗೆ ಹೋದೆ, ಆ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ನೋಡಿದೆ, ಈ ಪಿಜ್ಜಾ ತಿಂದು, ಇನ್ನೂ ದುಡ್ಡು ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ, ಕಮ್ ಆನ್, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಡೀಪ್ ಪಾಕೆಟ್, ರೈಟ್? ನೋ, ಮೈ ಪಾಕೆಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲೆಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಂಪ್ಟಿ, ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫುಲ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೈ ಜಡೆಲ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಜಡೆಲ್, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಂಪ್ಟಿ. ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್? ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ರೈಟ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ರೂಲ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಟ್ ರೂಲ್? ಸೊ ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ಎ ನೋಟೇಷನ್, ಐ ಕಾಲ್ ಜೀರೋ ಈವನ್, one odd. I use this as a notation. Now I do this adding with only these two. 0 plus 0, 0, that is even, plus even is even. 0 is even by definition. 1 plus 1, 2, odd plus odd, 2, this one, and 2, you go back to your usual integer, set of integers, 2 is even, right? I can write this as 0, I can take 2 as 0 according to my definition, because it is even. ಅಲ್ವ? 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3. ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಯೂಶುವಲ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟಿಜರ್ಸ್, ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಈವನ್, ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಆಡ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಈವನ್, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಸೊ ನೌ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಡೂ, ಐ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ define all even numbers, I identify with 0, and all odd numbers I identify with 1. Okay, and I add this as many times as I want, I would end up with either even or odd, that is for sure. So closure property is not affected. Alva, great. So I have a set consisting of only two elements, finite, and I had a set consisting of infinite number of elements. I do this addition with ease. I can do that addition with ease here. I am not thrown out of these sets. What is happening? See, in some sense, infinite sets and finite sets have what you would say, they conform with this kind of free addition operation. Should happen with multiplication also. Again, multiplication is bit that's again even, odd, even, odd. If you go by that, you will know. But either even or odd. And therefore, you don't have any problem. If you simultaneously operate also, you don't have any problem. What is simultaneously operation? Chalo. I don't have any problem. Ring operation. Am I right? And so, I have this, so I'm structured these two sets in some sense with these basic operations. I don't want to take big things here. Is that right, Raman? Do you have any?
No,
that's that I didn't know. I have taken integers, but I got a field. Because deliberately I wrote 11.
2 is prime.
2 is prime. Yep. 2 is prime. This is exactly an isomorphic copy of your binary ring or field. Computer science people cannot live without this. If this is taken out of their system, they will die. All computer scientists are dead. Please go and tell this to them. And so that that cannot be removed. Prime Minister cannot say, remove all J2 from there. No, it cannot happen. But they know the danger. So it is endangered kind of a thing. So this G modulo 2, modulo arithmetic we are trying to bring in here. Arithmetic and then modulo arithmetic. Basically to manage sets. Basically to manage infinite sets. That's the idea. So I need to look at these things. Basically, I have an infinite set. Again, what is this infinite? Horrible. They also use this symbol. Infinite. If money is infinite, fine. But that will not bring infinite happiness. That is, see, one infinite is a devil, the other one cannot be divine. So I the other thing, demon can also come. That's not the point. So your arithmetic comes into this picture. All right. So now I have two things here now. I start with a set, I look at this set, and then I see that in some sense the infinite sets, when I try to perform basic operations, it so nicely accommodates my confidence and then gives me back, come on, you add two integers, you take this integer, multiply two integers, you take this, use simultaneously distributive property with addition and multiplication, you take it, whatever it may be. But it doesn't happen with finite sets. But only 10 fingers I have got. My hand doesn't have infinite fingers. If I have infinite fingers like Ravan, even Ravan, 10 heads, 10 fingers only, only 2 hands I think. Only heads are 10. Fingers are 10, heads are 10. Things. The point is, when then, yeah. So I could structure this. This is a basic algebraic structure for the arithmetic of numbers. All right. Many big things happened. Just a while ago, I said root 2, right? My root 2 is not some p by n. If I deliberately make it to become p by m by n, deliberate, force it, what will happen? Some school arithmetic says, that is what school arithmetic says. If boy is intelligent, adhyena root thale ketta the master ge nan innu maja martini, he would say, so he is comfortable with this. So this is something like Aliyala Magalaganda, some variant form of this, okay. Alright. Now if it is equal to 0, which are those mn's for which this equation is satisfied? Which are those MNs for which same as something? Which are those MNs for which this is satisfied? Is equivalent to saying that which are the MNs which satisfies this? And we know that there are no such MNs because my M and N are relatively prime. They have no common factors among each other. If I write M square is equal to 2N square, I end up with ME1. M and N have a common factor greater than 1. That's a contradiction from the very definition that M upon N is a rational of the least reduced form in the form. And therefore that cannot happen. That's why we declare that root 2 is irrational. Isn't it? What is happening? Some very interesting thing is happening here. See, why I am trying to tell you all these things? Neevu idinella hogi mudugaru helbeku anta helta illa nanu. Yadavan tali tirka huduga eddu kelthane. Sari, idu root andre yenu sari da? Root limit of theta going to root on theta going to root andre yenu anta kelidre yenu madbeku nanu? Theta going to root 2. Yenu kelthare hudugaru? They are very smart. Theta going to root 2 antane. Theta going to root 2 andre enri idu? Theta should go to start from theta is equal to 0, theta is equal to 1, 0 point something, theta is equal to 0. Root 2 is 1 point something. Alitanka band, a number togond, band serkonde anta helbeku. Theta is equal to root 2 band anta helbeku. Alva? That is what it says. That is what calculus is all about. Theta has to go and sit on root 2. Bandidene. Theta is equal to root 2 kelta idithane. Root 2. Come on. What do you want? Point is, this is calculus process. This process is limiting process is calculus. Without infinity, no calculus. Without Rani, Raja illa. Rani illa, yanta Raja re. Ispet aatadalli Raja, Rani, Kalavar, Joker, ella idrane aata. Illa andre aata illa adu. Okay. If infinity is not there in calculus, calculus is not there in calculus. That is the whole point. So if something is happening here, just we invented integers with the negative numbers, stacks the natural numbers and including zero, rational numbers came as fractions, cooked up from these integers, give a pair of integers with that property, I can define a rational number. So there is a mapping. This is what Raman would talk in detail. Functions. Isn't it? You pick two integers, mn, m coming from z, n coming from z, map this to m upon n. Of course, my mn, mn, n not equal to 0. Of course, that is there. In fact, we said n positive, alva. So we said n positive. Only to take that kind of a thing. So what does it mean? Again, it is giving a very nice information that see the size of this set is same as size of this set. I will talk these things later in my next lecture. All right. They are of same size. ಇಬ್ಬರು ದೇವರುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ದೇವರು ದೊಡ್ಡವರು? ರೇಣುಕಾ ಯಲ್ಲಮ್ಮನ ಅಥವಾ ಮಾರಿಕಾಂಬನು? ಇಬ್ಬರು ದೇವರು ಅಂದ ಮೇಲೆ ದೇವರು ಒಳಗೆ ಸಣ್ಣ ದೇವರು ದೊಡ್ಡ ದೇವರು ಇದಲ್ಲ. ಇನ್ಫಿನಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಿನಿಟಿ. ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ದೇವರುಗಳು ಬೇರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾರಿಕಾಂಬ ಬೇರೆ, ರೇಣುಕಾ ಯಲ್ಲಮ್ಮ ಬೇರೆ. ಇನ್ಫಿನಿಟಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್? That is very important. Types of infinities. All these things. See, understanding sets or functions for that matter means we try to conceptualize this knowledge, how they synthesized these ideas over the generations and then comfortably could place for a curriculum and talk to the students, talk to the scientific community when it came to applications, and then they applied it. Technology wanted to be, because technology is expensive, math is the cheapest enterprise, academic enterprise. You need not invest anything on mathematics, I tell you. If somebody says that mathematics requires 1 crore rupees, then he must be cheating. But certainly if Intel says that I require 2 crores for this project, he is really worried. From where do I get these 2 crores? You want 2 crores? I have my tool with you. Come on, says 200 crores tool I'm having in my pocket. Mathematician says, today I was reading very interesting interview of one lady, Perlman, woman empowerment, a graduate from MIT. She goes into computer industry, comes up with her own algorithm on internet, talks about that. She made a big news. She says, innovations, if you are imaginative, if you can invent, innovate, that's enough. All the innovations first take their birth in mathematical thinking. This is the laboratory. Uske baad your computers. Nobody will give you one single pie if you don't give him the confidence that, look, this is the knowledge that you wanted to make 2 crores, right? Why 2 crores? 200 crores. He will sit like this. Come on, what is this? It will happen. So basically these things, these arithmetic structures were invented, innovated and practiced for computing. That is the pi. Pi is irrational. Transcendental, in fact, is it. So approximation to pi. Computing. Go nearest to the pi. Because quality is the hallmark. What calculus says is quality. Padmaraj knows. Image he takes. It's not good, sir. I will again fine tune it, he says. Because I want quality. So that is this calculus process. And so here, something is happening here. I invented a new set here. That new set, I would say, Q, I still reserve this symbol Q because I'm having a rational. Am I right? So I plug in these two things and then I have M upon N. And now I said M upon N is chalo. And therefore I will do like this. This is a new set, number set, unlike other numbers, because they are there. Vasantrao Potdar Polytechnic is not only meant for people who are residing in Telakavadi. They will also come from Hindavadi, they come from Sadashivam, they come from outside, they come from UP, something like that. So what is this set? This set is set. And what you will do again? Same. Add freely. Deep pocket. Spend as much as you want. That can happen then. The only thing is you have to specify the rules. That's all. And therefore, this set gets expanded. You start from N, you cross from Z, you come up with R, then you come up with C, then some number fields. These are already fields, as Raman was trying to tell. And then I have there these things, etc., 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 etc. All those things. And now you might have seen some computer pieces. They have written these things. Q root 2, they say. This is basically for computing. So I start with some simple set, like integers, like natural numbers. Then if you start with some arithmetic operations, you see very interesting things happening here. Now because numbers are comparable, therefore there is another interesting structure that you can introduce on number sense, namely a less than or equal to order. Order structure is another thing that computer scientists look for. Order. How much is the time? Over?
Still?
Half an hour. Wow. In Bhutramatti, time goes fast. Ladies, watch us. Okay. I don't break your head with these things. I don't want to do that. How do you get your infinite sets? I asked some question. How does one get an infinite set? A lot of apologies. I don't define what a function is. In fact, these arithmetic operations, all these are, they are functions only. They are called mappings, binary operations. I was telling Padmaraj one story like this. You take an orange tree. Okay? It bears infinite fruits. Right? Orange tree bears infinite fruits. Means very tempered tree. ಅಷ್ಟು ಕಿತ್ತಿದ್ರು ಇನ್ನೂ ಬರತ್ತೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಕೈ ಸುಸ್ತಾಗಬೇಕು ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಕೊಂಬೆ ಕಿತ್ತಿವೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೈ ಆರೆಂಜ್ ಟ್ರೀ. ಆಲ್ ರೈಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ, ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ದೊ, ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಇನ್ ಅರೇಬಿಯನ್ ನೈಟ್ಸ್, ಅಲಿಬಾಬಾ 40 ಚೋರ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ. Then brother goes, a greedy fellow, and then he goes on filling as much money as he grabs, all gold coins, everything. When he enters that dangerous place. Yeah. Then he takes gunny bags, right? His brother comes up with 2 gunny bags. This fellow takes some infinitely many gunny bags. But each gunny bag will contain only finite number of coins. So I pluck this. This is my function. I pluck oranges and put them in boxes. My box is bounded and I have a physical limitation to the box. After some stage, the box gets filled. Box 1, filled. Move this. Box 2 is in place. Because oranges are infinite, this plucking goes on. Box 2 is filled. Who this? So on one hand, I have an infinite set, which is in this case a tree bearing oranges. On the other hand, I have boxes which contain filled with finite number of oranges. And therefore, your finite sets are coming from infinite sets. And therefore, if you have infinite sets, you will get finite sets. If you have finite sets, after some stage, all sets will disappear. Even that is what seasonal fruits say. Hey, Allah Mugidu sir, Mundin sir, sir, money. Next season, Ratnagiri, Apus, next season. Because they exhaust for that season. So, these infinite sets will give birth to finite sets. So, my infinite set, N, please come. My infinite sets, N, gives birth to finite sets. What are these finite sets? Any guess? What are these finite sets? For each k, no, n k's. Your n k's are finite sets. Right? These are in abundance for each K. They are infinite, but each NK is finite. Each is finite, consists of exactly K elements. Am I right? All right. Now, question. Can I do this with every infinite set? My question is, can I do this with every infinite set? Can I get finite sets? You give some, there will be very interesting students will be there. You give them. They will love to crack such problems because they go and tell whom, today I got a very nice problem. Suppose if I have R, okay, can I get finite sets from R? I didn't think of this. Anybody would support his argument?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Can you volunteer?
There are no other rules, right?
Pardon?
The rule is just to extract finite sets out of R. That's simple, right?
That's simple, as simple as that. Okay.
R is a superset of L.
Huh?
R is a superset of L.
Right. So you can suck all this. So embedding, some kind of embedding is there. How do you get new sets? Because it's fancy to wear new shirt, you know. Somebody says, Alan Soli has got new shirts, I go and buy. How do you get new sets? From old sets?
That's one way.
That's one way.
And from mind one, you can conceptualize a set. That's one way.
Uh-huh.
And from old sets, Cartesian product.
Yes. Yes. Cartesian products. In calculus, you use this. Calculus is such a funny thing. Without Cartesian kind of things, no calculus. Without limit process, no calculus. Calculus is easy to get rid of. Infinity is easy to get rid of calculus. But Cartesian need not be there for calculus. That is a very advanced question. So you take Cartesian product, you get a new set. I want matrix. I want this set. See, you go for good sets. Very nice sets. In that case, matrix and matrices. Set of four. How do you get them? How do you get a matrix? I tell my students, in an array, I arrange some in n rows, n columns. And the matrix is n rows, m columns of entries, and then they may be coming from your number sets or blah blah blah. Right? How do you conceive this from the Cartesian point of view? Suppose I want a 2x2 matrix.
You go to n squared.
Good. A good guess. So 2 cross 2 matrix are A, B, C, D. Okay, I will define it over integers. Fine. So my entries are integers. How many of them are there? 4 of them are there. If I catch hold of 4 integers, I can cook up a 2 cross 2 matrix. That's what it says. See, this 4, 2 cross 2 is not a big deal, but it's very interesting, this universe of discourse. But if you have n tuple big rows of numbers coming up, then this matrix arrangement is a very convenient way of putting it into the. Supposing if I have n square entries, n tuple, say A11, that is the standard A1n, A21, A2n, AN1, ANN. Praveen, grapka idhe endre? Idhe, good. So all these AIs are integers. N square integers are there. Now I want to put them in as a matrix in n cross n rows. So I do this, map this. That's what Raman is supposed to do, this business. Put this into matrix. Without loss of generality, I will do this. Second row, first column. Second row, nth column. Yantro, nth column. Chalo. Matrix bandha. New set. What is this? Each aij is an integer, and therefore I have n square integers. N cross n, they are in all n square of them. And therefore, I cook up a Cartesian product of n square copies of Z and put them into Mn of Z, which is set of all n cross n matrices with entries in Z. Am I right? Cartesian product has come. New set. Alan Sole. My son nowadays, he does flip card and then comes. He makes a calling bell and then pay me 2000 rupees. Take this. these are all technology shocks. Appana nadathukonde idittam. Nam pocket alla kali. All pockets have become, infinite sets have become empty. But my wife, she is very generous. Whenever I ask, she gives me money. Because I take money only to give back her. All right. So Cartesian products are very interesting. You can cook up some interesting sets. Bandh mele en madado? Alan Soli hangi tand mele en madado? Hakko begale andre hakkonda girlfriend hatra koi addad begale inge. Elva martira elva. Matrix bandu en martira adanna? ಉಪ್ಪು ಖಾರ ಹಾಕೊಂಡು ನೆಕ್ಕೋದ ಏನು ಮಾಡೋದ ಏನಾದರೂ ಒಂದು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಹುಟ್ಟಿಸಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಪಾಪಕ್ಕೆ ಪುಣ್ಯಾರ್ಥ ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ವು ಇದಕ್ಕೂ ಅದೇ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ನಮಗೇನು ಐ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಟೂ ಮ್ಯಾಟ್ರಿಸಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಆ್ಯಡೆಡ್ ಟೂ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಐ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಟೂ ಮ್ಯಾಟ್ರಿಸಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಆ್ಯಡೆಡ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಟೂ ಮೆಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ನಂದೇನು ನಮ್ಮಪ್ಪ ಕೊಡಿಸಿದ ಹಾಕೊಂಡು ಆಟಿರ್ತೀನಿ ಸೊ ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ಟೂ ಮ್ಯಾಟ್ರಿಸಸ್ ಐ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಅಡಿಷನ್ addition is commensurable, compatible. I don't have any problem with addition, right? Because they're all square matrices. I took square matrices. Chalo, my life is simpler. Red mat shirt. Yes, all put that here. Agbada here, mana kagala. Alva. So this is C. You were not sleeping. You used to sleep in my lectures. I remember. Oh, I wish I could work here only. I will send my Veena, go there and teach. I will teach here. Do you allow? I don't think. It is difficult to teach here.
Yes.
Because I need not do anything there. It's very interesting. Compatible. There is a distinguished element, zero here also. See, these numbers, they are all very distinguished elements. Zero, one, with respect to these operations. Zero times this, one times multiplied times this. So like that, I have a zero matrix. Very distinguished element. Is equal to A. Inverse of a matrix is there. Look at this. For 1, minus 1, for 2, minus 2. After all, I'm picking up all these AIJs are coming from integers. So I don't have any problem. So for A, I have its additive inverse. I add them. So group property. So I get a matrix ring. Am I right? Again, these are all infinite. Their pockets are deep. These are all, what is this set? Set of all matrices, right? I'm sorry. Or infinite. For technology, this doesn't work. But no, this will go up. You can't stop infinite thing to go into computer. And computer cannot say that, come and sit in this. How do you feed this into computer? Just like what we did for integers, you will have to do the same thing here. The only thing that you need to replace is G modulo 2. Take entries as either zeros or ones. This is what computer scientists like. So your matrix entries are either zeros or ones. And therefore, computer configuration takes this. All right. But they are infinite. There's the levels. So this is very interesting way of getting new sets. Take a Cartesian product. You need not take two different sets. See, in calculus, we teach students, take X cross Y, Cartesian plane, we say. Plane, or XY plane, we say. So this X and Y need not be different. I can take X cross X. That is my R cross R. This writing board is exactly the replica of R cross R. 5 minutes. Watch is moving faster. Okay. So this is R cross R. Calculus wants this. Okay. This is what is called as a Euclidean. Yeah. I will reserve these things. Aage dekhi hai kya? Aage dekhi. Break. I think I will stop at this, and then if you have any questions, please feel free. For another couple of minutes, I will be very happy to answer your queries and then stop my talk. Anything? The best way to engage the students in the classroom on the first day at least I would say for another 10-15 days, socialize them. ಅವ್ರದ್ದು ಏನು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ರಿ, ಅವ್ರ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಏನು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಕೆಲಕ್ಲಸನ್ನು ಹೆದರಿಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಜ್ವರನೇ ಬಂದಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ. ಆ ಜ್ವರಕ್ಕೆ ನೆಗಡಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾತ್ರೆ ಕೊಡೋದು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಡೋಂಟ್ ಪುಟ್ ದೇಮ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಂಟಗ್ರಾಲ್, ಟೇಕ್ ಜೆರಾಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್, 100 ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್. ನಾಳೆ ಟೆಸ್ಟು, ಸಂಜೆಗೆ ನಿಂದು, ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗು ಈವ್ನಿಂಗು ವಾಮಿಟ್, ಮಧ್ಯಾಹ್ನ ಇಂಡೈಜೆಷನ್ನು, ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಇವೆಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಇವನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಮರ್ತುಬಿಡಿ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೀಚ್ ಥರೋಲಿ, ವೈ 100 out of 100 ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಕೋರ್ 1000 out of 100 ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡೂ ಎ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಕಿಂಡಲ್ ದೇಮ್, ಇಗ್ನೈಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿಸ್ತಾ ಫೌಂಡೇಶನ್ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್. ದೇಶಪಾಂಡೆ ಈಸ್ ಮೈ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ 30 years. ಹಿ ಡಿಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ, ನೋಬಡಿ ನೋಸ್, ನಾಟ್ ಮೆನಿ ನೋ. ಹಿ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬಾಗಲ್ಕೋಟ್. ಮೈ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ದೆನ್ 25 years. He used to come to me whenever he used to come to Belgaum. He used to come to Belgaum only to meet me. We used to spend hours and hours and then talk about things. Then some idea very fertile in his mind was very much haunting him for the last 10 years or so. I was also keen to encourage. In the year 2003, we initiated a MSI. Today we officially merged MSI with the Vista Foundation, which I forgot to tell that in the morning. Okay, and then he said, I want to establish this foundation in Bangalore. Then he said, Bangalore you take care, Belagavi I will take care. In between Chitradurga, Davanagiri, anybody is welcome. So topology is just to connect this line. Okay, and then that's what we are trying to do. And see that Belagavi becomes a hub of activities for this kind of exciting pedagogic things coming up in teaching and research. Future days, people may not know this, all these universities, I should not tell officially I am a university person, they are going to die, they are not going to be infinite, their calculus is very bad, foreign universities may come, they finish us, all right? And we don't know what will happen. At the end, a good teacher is remembered, and a good teacher matters. That is the message that I wanted to give. And Vista Foundation is having lots of such ideas, innovative ideas, to unfold in this city, and to the benefit of youngsters. Okay, mathematics is a young man's game. We old hacks, our innings are over. We may go as third umpires, that comes afterwards. Okay, so at the best what I can do, sit on this in the stadium and then clap for the sixers that these people hit. That's what the best I can do. And let us hope that we do many things. I am planning in September, maybe in September, I have a 2-day workshop on linear algebra applications in industry. So this is what we are trying to look at, because lot of things have impacted mathematics, from industry, from computers, from social sciences, economics, finance, all these things. Okay, and just one lifetime is not enough, but we can be choosy about all these things. So we have those things in our mind. And I really thank for your enthusiasm and interest that you showed in spite of some buns. The other day, suddenly something happened. Professor from US had come. Dinesh Thakur from University of Rochester. It was happy. Holiday was little bit messed up for Eid. And on that day, I had 30 of my students coming on holiday. And then they enjoyed a wonderful talk. I think that is recorded. We need to render it and then put it on YouTube or kind of a things. Okay, so we'll see that. Let top people come to Belagavi, talk to the young students. Okay, so we will try to do these things. I really appreciate Deshpande for his interest. And thank you very much for your appearance.